Hello, I'm Angelina Bernard, and this is Leading by Results, a monthly program produced by the New Hanover County Department of Social Services. November is National Adoption Awareness Month. Our focus today is on increasing the community's awareness of adoption, both the process and the need for adoptive parents in North Carolina and our local community. Adoption is one of the permanency planning goals mandated by the North Carolina Division of Social Services. Currently, there are over 100,000 children waiting for their forever families nationwide. New Hanover County provides adoption services to children in foster care. Additionally, services are provided for relative, independent, and step-parent adoptions. Our guests today are Lou Miller, adoption social worker with the Department of Social Services, and adoptive parent Michelle Ayer. They are joined today in honor of National Adoption Awareness Month to talk about adoption. First, we'll talk with Lou Miller, social worker for Department of Social Services. Lou, thank you so much for coming in today.
Thank you for having me.
Now, let us know a little about you. Tell us about your job as an adoption worker. What do you do?
Okay. When a child comes into the custody of the New Hanover County Department of Social Services, the department is mandated to immediately start making a permanent plan of care for that child.
Okay.
Many times, the child cannot be reunited with a parent, a relative, or a caretaker. In that instance, we start looking at adoption as a permanent plan for that child, because adoption does bring a forever home and family to a child.
That's correct. And we want children to have a forever home.
We do, and they want forever homes and families.
Exactly. Now, who are the children in DSS that may be potential adoptive children?
When we take children into protective custody at DSS, we work that permanent plan, and when reunification does not happen, we start looking at the termination of parental rights to legally clear that child for adoption. So we do have children in DSS custody who are foster children. They are in the legal custody of the department, but they are legally cleared for adoption. Our children come into foster care at any age from birth to 17, just under 18 years old.
Okay, and so is it a long process?
Generally, the longest piece of the process is the legal clearance. Once we can get legal clearance on a child, the adoption process moves fairly quickly. The legal part of getting legal clearance for the children would be the termination of parental rights in court, or if a parent voluntarily relinquishes parental rights.
Okay.
So the court process, the legal process, can sometimes be lengthy.
Can sometimes be lengthy for
yes.
children.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, are there different types of adoption?
There are different types of adoptions. The one adoption that you and I are talking about is an agency adoption, and that is when a child who is in DSS custody is adopted. We also, the department also is involved with step-parent relative adoptions.
Okay.
Those adoptions are just as they sound. When a step-parent or a relative desires to adopt a child, the clerk of court must have a report with a recommendation and some associated documents in order to complete an adoption. And the somebody that completes that report is the department. It is a service that is provided to the community. The Department of Social Services also gets involved in independent adoptions.
Yes.
They are sometimes called private adoptions or direct placement adoptions. This is a situation that the birth mother would find adoptive parent or parents with whom to place the child.
Mm-hmm.
And the department does the same process as with the other adoptions, with the report, the recommendation, and the associated documents, which generate the new birth certificate with the new adoptive parent's name or names, and the child's new adoptive name if there's a name change.
Okay, now is there a cost that we charge at the Department of Social Services?
There is, and it depends on what kind of adoption it is. Generally, with a child who is in DSS custody, the department absorbs the legal cost of legal clearance and the adoption. With a step-parent relative adoption, the DSS fee is $200. With the independent adoption, the fee is $1,000.
Okay, so from $200 to $1,000 could be the price of an adoption through the Department of Social Services.
Correct.
Okay, but that's cheaper than normal adoptions that we hear about sometimes where individuals go through private agencies, correct?
Considerably. Considerably more cost conservative.
Okay. And so you talked a little about this, but how do children become available for adoption through DSS? How do they ultimately become available? You talked a little bit. Could you do a little bit more talking about that?
Okay. When we start working with a child, initially upon their coming into protective custody, the general statutes in North Carolina allow us about 1 year to make a permanent plan for that child. We have to work a case plan to see if that child can return to a custodial parent, and if that does not happen, we proceed with the legal process for legal clearance for that child to be adopted, either through the court system or through voluntary relinquishments from the parent. So the child would remain in DSS custody, would remain a foster child until an adoption is finalized. We have many foster parents who foster to adopt.
We do have that going on at the department, and that's good because the children a lot of times are already in the foster parents' home.
Correct.
And so if the children become available for adoption, it is really good for them to be able to stay in that home and be adopted.
We get a lot of inquiries regarding families and parents who want to adopt, and we encourage people to foster to adopt. The process to become licensed as a foster parent is very similar to the process to become an adoptive parent. And if a child is able to go into this foster home, attachment and bonding starts happening right away, and that child blends into that family.
That's good news. Well, we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back to talk with you some more.
Okay.
Thanks, Lou. We'll take a quick break now and continue our discussion on adoption through the New Hanover County Department of Social Services when we come back. Welcome back to Leading by Results. I'm Angelina Bernard, and adoption is our topic today. Okay, Lou, who are the typical families who adopt through DSS? Or where do they come from?
We have families all over New Hanover County who come to us and are licensed as foster parents. Many of our licensed foster parents do adopt. They come from anywhere in the county. They're single people, they're married people, they're working people, they're stay-at-home people. So we have a variety of adoptive foster parents.
Is there an income that people have to make in order to adopt? Sometimes you hear that information that there is an income, you know, you have to have a certain amount of money. Let us know, is that a myth? Is it not true?
We don't ask for a dollar amount, but we do require that the adoptive parent be self-sufficient. In order to meet their own needs. We look at adoption subsidies as not an income for the family, but as a subsidy to meet any special needs that the child may have. So we just ask that the person be self-sufficient.
Okay, great. Now, can unmarried couples adopt? Sometimes people ask, you know, I'm unmarried, but I would like to adopt. Are they able to?
We do have single parents that adopt. So yes, we have married parents that adopt and single parents. So yes, there are a lot of single parents out there.
And that's good to know.
It is.
That really is. Now how long, we talked a little about this, so how long is the process to adopt? Let's say if the child is available for adoption, mm-hmm. from that point to the adoption is complete, what would you say the length of the time is?
Once we get that legal clearance and the child is legally cleared for adoption and we do actually start the adoption process, it is generally completed within 4 to 6 months.
Okay, so it's not that long after
the
clearance is done. So just getting the clearance for the child to be adopted. And when we talk about the child being cleared for adoption, You said the parents give up their right. What is that terminology again?
The termination of parental rights.
Yes.
We have to terminate parental rights either legally through the court system, or a parent may opt to voluntarily relinquish their parental rights. Some birth parents actually relinquish their parental rights and designate who they want to adopt their child. And it has happened in many occasions that the birth parent has relinquished parental rights to adoptive foster parents.
Okay.
That does happen.
All right. Now, we hear about this in the private sector. Does the department participate in open adoption, where the birth parent and the adoptive parent are meeting and conversating and communicating? Do we have that, or is that not something that we participate in at the department?
Well, in North Carolina, adoption cases are closed or sealed.
Okay.
However, when we have a child in department custody, we often participate in what is called shared parenting, where the foster parents work with the birth parents for the best interest of the child.
Okay.
While that parent may be making some efforts to rectify whatever problems brought that child into DSS attention and custody in the first place.
Exactly.
We have had foster parents who have been very supportive of birth parents attempting to get their lives back together. So we do participate in shared parenting, and it has been in some of those situations that the birth parents have relinquished to the adoptive foster parents.
Okay. But the whole process of adoption, and the reason why many, unfortunately, children are adopted through Department of Social Service is because there has been some maybe unsafe issues in their homes, and so maybe open adoption wouldn't be something that would be
best
thing. So we're looking at the safety of the child and
first,
the well-being of the child first, and
always. Once the adoption is finalized and the child is not in the custody of DSS, that decision and that responsibility falls on the adoptive parent to make that decision about whether contact with a birth parent should continue.
Okay. Now, the we have here the state of North Carolina. The governor did a proclamation. Could you talk a little about this?
Governor Perdue has proclaimed this month, November 2012, as Adoption Awareness Month.
And that's great.
So we are trying to bring adoption to the attention of people out there who may be considering adoption or considering fostering or maybe considering foster to adopt. Adoption is a wonderful thing. It brings permanence to children and forever families and homes for them. There are a lot of children out there with that need.
Exactly, and that's what we want people to know also, is that here in North Carolina and here in New Hanover County, there are a number of children who are available for adoption, and so you don't have to go to other countries or other places. You can adopt children right here in New Hanover County and make permanent homes for them.
That's correct. Nationwide, there are 408,000 children in foster care.
Wow.
Of those children nationwide, 107,000 children are cleared for adoption, 582 in North Carolina alone.
Wow.
So there are lots of children waiting for their forever families.
Great, great. Well, we're going to take another break, and we'll be back to talk some more.
Okay.
We're going to take another break. We'll continue our conversation with Michelle Eyre, one of many loving adoptive parents whose families have used the services of New Hanover County Department of Social Services.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Leading by Results, the New Hanover County Department of Social Services monthly television show. Joining us now is adoptive parent Michelle Eyre, here to talk with us about her experience with adoption. Welcome, Michelle. How are you?
I'm good. Thanks.
Thank you so much for coming out and talking with us about adoption. Yep. We were wondering, you know, what types of families, who would adopt, and so you're here to talk about adoption with us. Can you tell us a little bit about yourself and your family?
Sure. We moved down from Northeast Ohio about 5 years ago. My husband and I were married 5 years ago, and it was second marriage for both of us. Neither of us had had any children of our own, and my husband transferred and works for GE, and I work from home about 30 to 40 hours a week for a company out of Florida. And we went through the foster to adopt process, and we adopted our six-year-old daughter last fall. So she has kind of made our family complete and is active, and now we're very active in all the community events and school and all that good stuff. So
wow, that is great. So you did the foster to adopt process, and so your daughter that you adopted, she was in your home as a foster child?
She was actually in another home as a foster child, and they did not want to adopt. So when the plan changed to adoption, that's when they started looking for a family that was wanting to adopt, and then she, you know, we did visits with her, and then eventually she came to live with us and, you know, was still a foster child at that time until she was cleared for adoption.
Okay. So how long had you been fostering before you decided that you wanted to adopt your daughter?
Sure. We had always wanted the intention to adopt, but we had fostered for probably close to 6 months to a year before we had her. So, yeah, it was close to a year.
Okay. And so why did you consider adoption through DSS? Was it because you had already started the process with foster care?
No, it actually, I had a friend at work that had adopted through DSS and another that had become a foster parent through DSS. So in talking with them, and we were starting to think about having a family, it really just seemed the way to go. We were a little bit older, so we were not interested necessarily in an infant child when we wanted to adopt. We just wanted to be parents to somebody that needed parents.
Yes.
As we looked into that, we thought fostering would be a way for us to know, number one, do we really want to be parents? And, you know, is this a good fit for us? And then also it gives you an opportunity to know the child and to have local support afterwards too. I think you just you have that benefit, which is really nice.
That is really nice. Now, what are the qualifications to become adoptive family?
You have to go through about 30 hours of training. It's twice a week, 3 hours a night, and it's like 5 or 6 weeks long, and that really teaches you what it is like to become a foster parent or an adoptive parent and kind of the rules and regulations of the agency, as well as teaches you how to share parent with the biological family. So you have that. You also have to go through a home study. As Lou mentioned before, you know, there's maybe not a set income, but you certainly have to be able to provide for that child and be willing, you know, to do that and able to do that. So, you know, as long as you have a safe, loving home and the means to provide and, you know, can go through that training and pass your home study, you're good to go.
All right. That's great. Now, is there, we talked about, Lou had talked about a fee. What was your process with the fee with adopting?
That's another huge benefit of DSS. I mean, there are just so many children here within the United States, as you guys have mentioned, that need families, and you know, that was another reason we chose to adopt here locally. And with that, there were no fees involved. The agency picked up all of those. I think, you know, there was an $85 registration fee that we got reimbursed for. So, you know, there was no out-of-pocket expense at all for us.
And that's something that people should know.
Yes.
That adoption can be relatively inexpensive and not the thousands and thousands of dollars.
Right.
So that's great. Now, what challenges did you go through in the adoption process? Would you say there were some challenges or?
Sure. I think, you know, in any adoption process, there are challenges. They just may be different through DSS. And, you know, the biggest challenge I think we had was just, you have to be patient. You have to be open-minded. It's a risk. You know, when the child's placed with you, it is a legal risk because you don't know necessarily, are those parents' rights going to be terminated? Are they going to relinquish rights to you? You know, you don't know what judge is going to hear that case and decide differently. So you have to be prepared for that emotional kind of roller coaster that you're on through that whole process. And I think that was the biggest challenge. I mean, you have the challenge of the child itself, and you're bonding to him or her, and, you know, getting used to this new little person in your family or your home, but just the emotional roller coaster. And, you know, in our experience, the birth mother ended up relinquishing rights to us before it got to the point of termination.
Okay.
So it was, you know, it was really good for everybody.
All right. Now, what have been some personal rewards, you would say?
I think just our daughter herself, she's just a blessing to our family, and, you know, has allowed us to have the joys and challenges of parenthood, and to see how she has progressed and changed just brings a lot of joy into your life, and she brings a lot of laughter into ours.
Okay, and what would you advise others about adopting a child through the Department of Social Services, or just adopting?
Sure. I think as other parents, you just have to, again, keep an open mind. You know, the right child will come, and you might have to be patient for that child to come, but he or she will show up. And so keeping an open mind, being prepared, making sure that it is the right fit for you and your family, that you really want to be a parent and that this is the way you want to go about it, I think is the most important thing.
Okay. Now, just this past weekend, there was an adoption picnic for the families. Did you attend that?
Yeah, we did. Yeah, we try to go every year. And it's just nice because, again, with the local, adopting locally, you have that support system. You have other families that are there that have fostered, that have adopted, and you get to know those families, and the kids all kind of play together, and they just had a ball and a great time. So it was a nice turnout. It was a really nice event.
That's great. That's great. Well, thank you so much for coming out today, talking with us, giving us this information. Lou, anything you want to say last to the community about adoption?
Call us. Give us a call. Please don't hesitate. If you're considering fostering or adopting or have questions about fostering to adopt, I'll throw out Alice Moore's name, 798-3566. We'll be certainly glad to talk with you, answer questions, give you information.
All right.
Thank you for your time and your interest.
Great, great. Thank you, ladies.
You're welcome.
Thank you for coming out today, and I'm sure that the information that was given is going to be very helpful to all those out there in the community.
Thank you.
November is National Adoption Awareness Month. Our guests today have given you a wealth of information on the adoption process through the New Hanover County Department of Social Services. If you are considering adoption through social services, we would encourage you to contact us, Alice Moore or Brian Bochnick at the New Hanover County Department of Social Services. The main number is 798-3400. That's our show for now. I'm Angelina Bernard. Thanks for watching.